In today's video, we are going to create a cursive handwriting workbook in PowerPoint, which is one of the most profitable low-content books on Amazon. Also, at the end of video, I will show you how to use the ready-to-use interior that I uploaded on my Gumroad shop and create a cursive handwriting workbook. You can follow these steps almost on every software that allows you to upload your own fonts. So even if you are working with other softwares, as long as you use these steps, you can create your cursive handwriting workbook. But in this video, I will use PowerPoint. If you are new to my channel, welcome. This channel is all about making passive income from Amazon KDP and other sources of print on demand. If you are interested in these types of videos, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to receive a notification as soon as I publish new videos of this series. Okay, let's first have a quick look at some of the cursive handwriting workbooks on the Amazon. So as you can see, a cursive handwriting workbook can be for kids, teens, and adults. And although the font is exactly the same with some changes, you can aim it at a specific group. For example, if you add some animals pictures and make the font slightly bigger, you can change this book to have a handwriting book for kids just like this one. Okay, let's first review the bestseller book in this niche. As you can see, this book is the bestseller rank on cursive handwriting workbook. This book price is $5.95 with 109 pages. Let's see how much this author is earning for each sale. As you can see, this author is earning $1.43 for each sales. I'm using the Helium plugin to see the number of sales in the last 30 days. So click on the X-ray button here. It will open the pop-up for you. You can find the number of sales in the last month here. As you can see, this book sold 6,960 books in the last 30 days. Now we just need to multiply these two numbers to calculate the estimated profit of this book. As you can see, this author earned around $10,000 in the last 30 days just from this book. Before I show you how you can create a cursive handwriting workbook, I want to mention that since this book is in the education category, you need to make sure to check all of your words and sentences in the cover and interiors. If parents find any spelling errors on your book, they will definitely post a bad review for your book on Amazon. Also, I recommend reading other books' reviews to make sure you improve those things in your book. So in order to create this book, we need two components. One is the line interior and the other is the font. And the particular dotted cursive font, which is a bit tricky thing to find. But don't worry, because I found the exact font that is used on most of these books on the market. Of course, it's up to you if you want to use this font or something different. Okay, let's get into the work and create our interior. Today we are going to use PowerPoint. But as I mentioned before, you can use any other graphical softwares as long as they allow you to upload your own font. First, let's download our font. Go to bbfonts.com, click on free fonts, and click on learning curve rule and download it from here. Just remember, this font is free for commercial use at the moment that I'm recording this video, but please check the licensing and terms of use by yourself before using it in your book. To add the font to your PowerPoint, you need to install this font. So first download it, and then double click on your font and click install fonts. Now open your PowerPoint. Go to the design, then page setup, and change the size to 8.5 by 11 inch and hit OK. Let's also find out what should be set for the bleed. I'm using Amazon's spreadsheet for this. As you can see, we need to set 0.25 inch on edges and 0.375 as gutter margins. Now click on the text box and click on the page. Change the font from here to learning curve ruled and enter your letter. I'm going to use a solid font as an example for the first letter and rest would be the dotted letters. So I'm gonna fill out this page and we will get back in a few seconds. Okay, as you can see, I created an interior page for a cursive book. Now that I create the first page, which is the letter A, we need to repeat this for all the letters. So let's say I want to create the same design for letter B. So I simply go to the replace here, and then I want to replace all A's with B. So based on the size of the font, you might have to add or remove a letter or a space to make all the lines look even. Since you are using PowerPoint, you can just create different slides for each letter. So you will have a slide for each of your letters, and you don't need to export each page. And at the end, you can easily export all of your pages at same time to PDF. As I promised, I want to also show you how to use the interior you downloaded from my Gumroad shop. First, go to my Gumroad shop and click on the cursive handwriting interior. Enter any price you afford and click on add to cart. On the top right hand, you will get a pop-up. If you didn't, just click on this cart and then click on checkout here. Enter your email address and Gumroad will send you a copy of this file to your email. Now go to PowerPoint and drag and drop the file you just downloaded and place it between your guides. Now to find a cursive font, I'm gonna go to fontspace.com and search for cursive handwriting. Make sure to select the commercial use right here, and then I'm gonna use this font called Learning Curve BV. Before using any fonts in your book, make sure to check the license. Now that we have the font, just select this new font in PowerPoint and add the letters here like this. So this is how you would use the template with the cursive font. If you don't have the time to follow these easy steps, you can also use websites like Creative Fabrica or Fiverr. Just open Creative Fabrica and search for cursive handwriting. As you can see, there are lots of products that you can buy and use them in your cursive handwriting book. You can find a link to all of these websites down in the description. You have got your font, which is free to use and has a commercial use, and also the line paper you can get for free. So it's just up to you and your imagination. Do a bit of research on the types of interiors and look at some examples for inspiration. So that's it. I hope this video was useful for you. Once again, thank you very much for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and also hit the subscribe button. Until the next video, goodbye.